signed earlier today, and enforcement can start immediately. But as I heard here earlier, one of the bigger concerns is to have voluntary compliance. We want people to be able to freely surrender any of these drugs that they have now, and that's why our good partners with the Drug Enforcement Administration a couple of years ago started the Drug Take Back program that they invited us to participate in, and the state police and numerous law enforcement agencies have participated in that over the last 2 years. And everyone will have an opportunity again this April 28th, which is a Saturday, all across the state of Indiana, every state police post except for the toll road, to come by, no questions asked, drop off any of these drugs, ones that are now covered, or any other drug for that matter, be it legal or illegal, or just old prescriptions in your home. So we encourage people to take advantage of that. It's been a very successful program.
Thank you very much.
The penalties to businesses, 1 year shutdown, seems pretty harsh. I mean, you three are all Republicans, tend to look out for business, and here you are, the government shutting businesses down. Are you okay with that? Is this
This is language that was agreed upon by everyone, including those what are referred to as head shops in broader bowl. Retail Indiana has agreed to these terms. They believe that they won't be, the good actors, if you will, are not selling this. And thus, they're not fearful of this at all. What their more concern was, and correct me if I'm wrong, Representative Smith, is the concern was that they would have a rogue clerk that would be working outside of their policies, and that's why we're protecting them from selling it out the back door under the counter. So, bottom line is everyone agreed with the language that we have.
Yeah.